Welcome once again. Friends, in this session, we are going to discuss digital modulation techniques. In the last video lectures, we have talked about baseband data transmission. In this method, the digital data is transmitted directly over a low pass type channel. In baseband data transmission, there is no need of carrier or any modulation technique. And such type of baseband transmission is suitable only for a short distance using low pass type channels such as twin wireline or coaxial cables. After this, in this session, we are going to discuss different digital modulation technique that is based on the concept of transmitting digital data after modulation of high frequency sinusoidal carrier. And this makes the possibility of transmitting digital data over long distance. In this digital techniques, microwave, radio link, satellite channel, etc. are used as a communication channel, hence called passband data transmission or digital continuous wave modulation techniques. Now we discuss passband data transmission in detail. Passband data transmission is also called digital continuous wave modulation technique because here digital data is transmitted using high frequency sinusoidal carrier signal. Here the characteristic of high frequency sinusoidal carrier such as amplitude, frequency or phase is switched or keying in according to the incoming binary data. And the techniques are amplitude shift keying, ASK, frequency shift keying, FSK and phase shift keying, PSK. ASK, FSK and PSK are the special case of AM, FM and PM respectively. In ASK technique, the digital data modulates the amplitude of the carrier. In FSK, the frequency of the carrier is modulated or switched according to the input digital data, while in PSK technique, the phase of the carrier is switched or keyed in according to the digital data. Next, we discuss some basic features of digital modulation techniques. During modulation process, that is called switching or keying process, the amplitude, phase or frequency of high frequency sinusoidal carrier get transformed into a pair of possible values, that is according with symbol 0 and symbol 1. And correspondingly, we have binary ASK, binary PSK and binary FSK signals or waves. So in digital modulation techniques, we focus more on a high frequency sinusoidal carrier signal that is expressed by C function t equals to AC cos within bracket 2 pi FCT plus phi C. Here AC is carrier amplitude, FC is carrier frequency and phi C is carrier phase. In binary ASK, carrier frequency and phase remains constant. Only the carrier amplitude AC is keyed or switched between two possible values to represent symbol 0 and symbol 1. And in binary PSK, carrier amplitude and frequency remains constant, but carrier phase phi C is switched between two possible values, such as 0 degree and 180 degree to represent symbol 0 or symbol 1. And at last, in binary FSK, carrier amplitude and carrier phase remains constant, but the carrier frequency is keyed or switched between two possible values, that is corresponding to the symbol 0 or symbol 1. This concept becomes more clear in our mind after illustrating the waveform of binary ASK, PSK and FSK. Initially, we consider a sinusoidal carrier signal and input binary data. For example, 01101001, where each binary symbol having a bit duration TB. First is amplitude shift keying. In ASK, the amplitude of the carrier is switched according to symbol 0 or symbol 1. And commonly in ASK, one of the amplitude is 0. For example, symbol 1 is represented by the presence of carrier at constant amplitude, and symbol 0 is represented by the absence of carrier. And the resulting transmitted ASK signal is shown in figure. Next is binary PSK. In this scheme, the carrier phase is switched between two possible values, that is 0° or 180° phase shift. Here, symbol 0 is represented by 180° phase shift, while for symbol 1 there is no phase change, that is 0°. And at last, in case of FSK, we represent symbol 0 as a frequency of the carrier change to just half. And for symbol 1, the frequency of carrier is unchanged. Here, in FSK scheme, we consider a constant phase. Also, for FSK, we may represent symbol 0 or symbol 1 for any other frequencies. For example, we consider F1 for symbol 0 and frequency F2 for symbol 1. Here, F1 and F2 is different frequency as compared to carrier frequency. Now, after observing the waveform of ASK, PSK and FSK technique, we conclude that ASK having discontinuous envelope due to the absence of amplitude for one of the symbol, but in case of PSK and FSK, there is a constant envelope and preferred practically as compared to ASK, because ASK having non-linearities in amplitude in case of microwave radio or satellite channel. Also, on the basis of observation of waveform, PSK and FSK cannot be differentiated easily by merely looking their waveform. Next, after discussing the basic concept of digital modulation techniques such as ASK, PSK and FSK, we move to the demodulation techniques. So, for demodulation purpose, two methods are used. First is coherent or synchronous detection, and other is non-coherent or envelope detection. In coherent or synchronous detection, the locally generated sinusoidal carrier is used at the receiver side. And for proper detection, this locally generated carrier must be in phase locked with the carrier at the transmitter side. While in case of non-coherent or envelope detection, there is no need of phase lock, and this make it a simple method of detection but having a higher probability of an error. For discussing digital modulation techniques such as binary ASK, PSK and FSK, we first go through some basic features of sinusoidal carrier signal. As we have already discussed in last video lectures, the carrier signal in analog communication is given by expression C function T equals to AC cos within bracket 2 pi FCT plus phi C, where AC is carrier amplitude, FC is frequency of the carrier and phi C is phase of the carrier. But in case of digital communication, where we have a pair of bits, that is symbol 1 or symbol 0, that having some bit duration denoted by TB. So in this case, the carrier amplitude is represented in terms of bit duration T suffix B. For this, we first determine sinusoidal average power, that is PS, which is equals to half of the square of amplitude carrier, that is 1 upon 2 AC square. From here, we can write carrier amplitude AC equals to under root of twice of PS. And the corresponding carrier signal C function T is equals to under root of 2 into PS cos within bracket 2 pi f c t plus phi c. Now, the sinusoidal power Ps can be written in terms of bit duration Tb and bit energy E suffix B. That is, sinusoidal power is equals to bit energy upon bit duration, having unit joule per second or simply called watt. So, the modified carrier signal C function T becomes under root of 2 Eb upon Tb cos within bracket 2 pi fct plus phi c. Now, but in practical case, we assume that unit energy is measured over 1 bit duration, that is, unit energy per bit duration. So, in practical case, we consider bit energy equals to 1 joule and corresponding carrier signal is equals to under root of 2 upon Tb cos 2 pi fct plus phi c. And this is a modified carrier signal used for digital modulation techniques such as binary ASK, PSK and FSK. Now, after modulation process, we have modulated signal. That is simply a product of incoming binary wave B function T and carrier wave C function T. And assuming carrier phase set to 0, that is for our convenience. So, the modulated wave S function T is equals to under root of 2 upon Tb into B function T cos 2 pi fct. Here, the carrier frequency is far greater than the bandwidth of the binary wave B function T. So, practically, in digital communication, we assume unit energy that is measured over 1 bit duration. And for passband transmission, the expression for bit energy is given by integration of mod st square into dt, taking limit 0 to Tb. And here, S function T is the modulated wave equals to under root of 2 upon Tb into B function T cos 2 pi fct. Here, we consider carrier phase equals to 0 for our convenience. So, after putting the value of S function T and using the formula of cos square theta, the bit energy can be simplifying and having two terms. In the second term, mod of bt square becomes constant over one complete cycle of cos 4 pi fct and this second term becomes 0. So, the approximate bit energy Eb equals to 1 upon Tb integration mod bt square into dt, taking limit 0 to Tb. And this is called transmitted energy signal per bit. Now, we note a point. In digital modulation techniques, binary ASK is the simplest form and used earlier in radio telegraphy system. And the binary ASK is based on the principle of on-off signaling, where the binary data stream B function T can be represented in terms of bit energy. That is, according to the expression of transmitted signal energy per bit. From here, mod of bt square is taken outside the integration and after solving integration, bit duration Tb is cancelled. So, bit energy can be written as mod of bt square. And accordingly, the binary stream B function T can be written as under root of bit energy. So, in order to describe binary ASK, that is a type of on-off signaling, the binary data stream is equals to under root of bit energy, that is for binary symbol 1 and 0 for binary symbol 0. And our next discussion is binary ASK. Here we use binary data stream BT equals to under root of EB for binary symbol 1 and 0 for binary symbol 0.